Hey, Jewel. Sorry about the other day. I've been preparing for your launch a long time. But when your ship finally left Earth, well, I haven't cried that hard since your mother died. I know I can't talk to you directly since you're already in cryosleep. And even if I could, the communication lag would just get worse the farther you got from Earth. So I thought, why not record some messages and send them to you for when you woke up? Consider them half official, half private. Well, guess your old dad can't mope around forever. We've got lots of work to do. Research to make sure the Far Eden project succeeds. I'm gonna do all I can to support you and the other heroes on that ship. And that includes Mag, who I hope is sleeping close beside you. Until next time. Love you, kiddo.
Well. Time to travel, Violet.
A-okay!
Ugh, these crystals look corrupted, just like the hostile Corebots.
Yeah.
to me.
Thank you.
This ought to be good.
You've gotten it by now. The letter of apology from my superiors for me questioning your authority. I have to attend a disciplinary hearing next week. Unlike you, I'm not millions of kilometers from Earth. They can't remove you from your ship even if they wanted to. But they won't hesitate to fire me. I'm not mission critical. I won't waste my time asking you to put in a good word on my behalf. Even though every action I took was for the safety of you and your crew. When I'm gone, you can ignore the rules as much as you like. Land on Far Eden, declare a special kingdom for you and your Corebots, and never talk to Earth again. What do I care? Best of luck to you and this Victor Corebot who made the repair. You won't hear from me again.
Good. Violet.
Thank you.
Okay, Violet, let's go. still too tough to pull.
Let's do this, Violet.
Discovered Far East. They called it a new horizon for humanity. But all I knew was that it would be the place that would take my daughter away from me. Don't get me wrong. I was so proud watching you compete to become a member of the Far Eden team. And I knew you leaving was partly my fault. Since you were little, it seemed all we did was talk about space. About how incredible it would be to explore other worlds. You're so much like your mother. Brave, kind, a little reckless. Earth was too small for her. And, I guess, too small for you too. What makes me happy is that we'll be able to work together, even though we'll be far apart, to test my new invention, the Core AI. If we succeed, we won't just have built humanity a new home. We'll have revolutionized the relationship between humans and artificial life.
What's up, Violet?
A-okay!
Okay, Violet, let's go. Violet, I got places to go. Again. Take a look. Thank you.
Thank you.
I do. You can find it. Look. Begin. Here, Seth. See what you can find. Got the scent, Mac? Take a look, buddy. Mac, dig in. Let's see if there's anything here. You got the scent, Mac? Take a look around. Mac, dig in. Let's do a search. You got the scent, Mac? Find it. Mac, dig in. Got the scent, Mac? Dig in.
Time to travel, Violet.
Come here, buddy. This ought to be good.
Thank you.
Over here, Seth.
Good.
Okay, Violet, let's go. Let's do this, Violet.
Thank you.
See what we got.
Thank you.
go. To me. Come to me. Got it.
Thank you.
Bingo!
Thank you.
This ought to be good. Come here, buddy.
Open sesame.
Thank you.
Smash that, Duncan. Can't open it from this side.
Open up.
Got it. Okay, Violet, let's go.
Okay!